happening, Munchers? My name is Harsh.
My name is Shreyas.
Welcome back to Muncher Movie Awards, better known as
Munchys.
And what are we doing today about it?
We're doing best twist. This usually comes right at the end of the movies. Could be plot turning, could not. Usually concluding, obviously. The reason why we're doing this and many other nominations is because the Oscars suck, guys.
There's so many good nominations and so many good categories that Oscars are missing out on, and we're obviously covering all of them. So we're getting bigger than the Oscars, guys. Join the movement.
Yo, you heard it here first.
Let's do this.
So before we get into our nominations, we had a lot to go through for our honorable mention. We finally settled on freaking J.K. Simmons from Spider-Man Far From Home.
Playing J. Jonah Jameson.
Yes, from Tobey Maguire universe.
Right. And the only reason why I would consider this as a twist is because it just throws the entire MCU into such a chaos.
Yeah.
You have no idea what's happening. I have multiverses merged. Has the snap done something where J. Jonah Jameson, who was Tobey Maguire's J. Jonah Jameson, come to this world now?
Right.
What's happening?
Absolutely. And this is so weird. It's almost like Sony, Marvel, Disney, like sort of playing around with this.
Absolutely.
You know, ownerships are being, you know, flipped up here and there. Rent, lease, all of that jazz. Are they getting Spider-Man? Are they not getting Spider-Man? Tom Holland is crying like a baby, spilling spoilers as he does.
Right.
But yeah, but this made sense. We also covered this in our best cameo video. You should check that out as
Check it out.
But yeah, as a twist, like he said, it sets up and opens up so much.
Right.
Venom, Carnage, Sinister Six.
Multiverse of Madness.
Who knows, bros?
Nomination number one, in no particular order, they're talking about Sharon Tate and a murder in Once Upon a Time in Hollywood. Quentin Tarantino coming back. He's got Brad Pitt.
Damn.
He's got Leonardo DiCaprio.
Damn.
He's taking on some topics that are actually, you know, from real life.
Yep.
We're talking about Margot Robbie as Sharon Tate.
Right.
And we all know Sharon Tate was actually really brutally murdered in real life.
Yep.
But Quentin Tarantino steps in. He's like, where's all the fun in Hollywood? It's missing. Let me come in and do my thing. He killed Hitler before.
Ooh.
He saved Sharon Tate this time.
Yes.
And what a way to do it.
Absolutely, man. I mean, that last scene just brings the whole movie together. It's so weird, like, when everything is said and done, Sharon Tate actually comes out and finally meets him. It's so
this
cool.
Friends, Leonardo DiCaprio.
Absolutely. And in terms of actual fact, it was not just her, but it was a double murder. It was her pregnant belly and the brutal stabbing and all that stuff.
Right.
But yeah, just Brad Pitt, his character, the dog too. Oh my god, that scene just threw everything out of
order. And this is the penultimate scene in the entire movie.
Right.
This is what sets up the movie, this is what makes the movie enjoyable, and this is the entire Quentin Tarantino-esque thing that you were waiting for throughout the movie.
Nomination number two, we have Joker. Oh my god, so this guy, disillusioned in his own world, we all think he's killing it with Zazie Beetz's character. At least some sort of sliver, some silver lining in his life. But we find out he sits on the couch and oh my god.
Man, this movie, there's just so much to talk about in this movie, and this scene just, I was like, what just happened? And let me clueless, because anytime you got an unreliable narrator as your protagonist, you know this movie's gonna be messed up.
Throws it open.
Shutter Island did something similar, and this movie does something, this entire sequence, so well.
Right.
I think it had this completely changed the movie for me.
Totally. Yeah, I mean, it's almost like they didn't have to show it. They sort of replayed those same instances when he thought that she was with him.
With him, right.
And then to do it when she's not there and he's looking at her, he's talking to her, and it just freaks
and
you out.
And it gave me goosebumps, man. Yep. Todd Phillips, props to you. Nomination for Best Switch number 3 is Us.
Yo.
Lupita Nyong'o.
Yeah.
And the massive, massive reveal that comes towards the end, that Lupita Nyong'o, the one that everyone's always cared about, the one who has a proper family, is actually the one from the underground.
She's a clone.
Absolutely. And she switched up when they were kids, back at the beach house.
Right.
You know,
the mirror house.
Exactly, mirror house. When everything goes down. And I really like how Jordan Peele's directed this movie.
Yeah.
And the way you can actually watch it a second time and just see it from a completely different perspective and a lens.
Right.
Knowing that this Lupita Nyong'o is not the actual protagonist.
Yeah, that's exactly what we said when we figured it out in the end. And it's done so well. Like, the kid just looks at his mom and he's like, something's off.
He sees through her. Sees through. There's something off about my mom. Even though she is the woman who gave birth to me.
Right.
There's something off about her.
Right. And you could tell, like, she's super quiet when, as a kid, when the switch actually happens. She's sitting at the psychiatrist's right. office and she's mum. Like, she doesn't say a single thing.
Right.
Parents think there's something wrong with her, trauma, etc., etc.
She's actually analyzing how this world operates and she's trying to blend in.
Right. So
Jordan Peele, man, what a way to pull it off, and I love this movie.
Yes, I mean, this guy does funny stuff. For him to do Get Out and now this, he knows what he's doing.
Massive props.
Nomination number 4, we have Knives Out. It's your typical whodunit movie. I foolishly thought that it's based on a novel because of how it actually moves.
Yeah, but it's an original screenplay and it's by Rian Johnson, man. Right. This guy did Looper, this guy did Star Wars, The Last Jedi.
Yeah.
And I really enjoy this movie. The big switch up is when, you know, Chris Evans kind of switches up the drugs, trying to poison his grandfather.
Yeah.
But we all find out that Ana de Armas, that's her name.
Cutie.
She actually gave him the right dosage and he wasn't drugged.
Right.
He actually ends up killing himself over nothing. And when you realize this, it actually hits you like a train, because in the movie everyone's trying to, you know, find out who's killed the guy,
right.
who's after his inheritance and all that. And this movie does such a nice job of, you know, establishing all these characters, and then there's Daniel Craig.
Oh damn, that accent, Texan, is it maybe? I don't know, but holy shit, he can do some real stuff, yeah?
Absolutely. This entire movie is a blast, man. Nomination number 5 comes from Avengers Endgame, and we're talking about something that happens 15 minutes into the movie.
Yep.
What's happening about
it? Not prepared for it at all, but damn, Thor just goes straight for the head.
Right.
We know that in Infinity War, that was his missing thing, it brought him down, he's down and dusted. Give him 10 minutes in this movie, he's back,
yep.
But it's still not redemption, right? So we have no idea what happens from here. Thanos is dead, the stones don't exist. What
the
happens
Avengers
now?
Are clueless as to what's gonna happen,
right.
What do you do? And then it just skips to what, 5 years later?
Right.
And I think that for a movie to do is super duper ballsy.
Right.
A studio like Marvel to do.
Right.
Just kill off Thanos in the first 15 minutes. And I think it was done supremely.
Absolutely well. That brings us to the end of this video. This was our last nomination video. This was our last nominee. Jesus Christ, I can't wait for next week, Feb 10th. Stay tuned. Save the date. Oscars are copying us again. I don't know why they're doing this, although we're only in our first year. So.
Right. We'll be announcing all the winners on Feb 10th, same day as Oscars, as usual. And yeah, do, you know, let us know if you missed out on any, you know, nominations
right.
for this category for the best twist of 2019.
Right.
Like, share, subscribe as usual, guys, and be back for more. Nomination number 5, this is in no particular... 1. Yeah, I think nomination 5 he's doing...
That's his job. Like a new job.
Bart is so happily doing...
I'm like, who's the here?
Okay. We're doing twists or cameos? Me, my bad, sorry. We're doing twists, alright, sorry. Oh God.